Hello guys, and welcome back to another episode of City Skylines with me, Pug Gaming. Now, I'm sure a lot of you have already noticed this amazing mod on the workshop called Move It by SamsamTS. It's absolutely incredible. It's changed my way of playing this game dramatically. And I thought in tribute for him, and also to let you guys know of the few little tricks that I've found you can use or actually do with this mod, I thought I'd just do a quick video to sort of outline what is possible. So the one that everyone's been sort of talking about straight away is obviously the actual movement of the roads. You can change the angles by clicking them. You can also raise them up and down even when they're already placed. So things like this, if you're doing an underpass, it's amazing. You can literally just plop the road where you want and don't really worry about anything until you get to the end. So here, as you can see, I'm placing this mod, the road down, and straight away you can see, oh, I'm a bit out of shape here. Whereas normally I'd have to delete that part and sort of replace it down again. What you can do now is when it's already placed, you can pick it up, you can move it around, you can rotate it. You can pretty much do anything you want to get that into the position you need it to be. So once you've positioned the underpass in its location, this is when the fun bit begins. So you can use the amazing Move It tool to lower and higher the road itself by clicking on the nodes that highlight up. So you can see there's two nodes there. There's one for the road, which I'm moving around now. This is going side to side, as you can see, a bit better from this angle. And if you press the page down and up button, you can raise the actual road up and down. You can also click on the actual supports as well. You can move those to the bottom of the earth so they aren't there at all. So in some cases you don't want to have these pillars around, so doing that just makes aesthetically things a lot better. And of course, not only with the road you can move around, you can move the actual assets and props as well, which does make life extremely easy in terms of detailing and getting areas built exactly how you want. The annoying thing before this mod was the fact that when you place something down, the only way to move it really was to click on it, and then if you was able to, some of the props wouldn't allow you, but you could change it from that drop down menu. But otherwise it was a case of deleting and replacing and hoping you get in the right position next time round. So in the same way as you do the roads, obviously on this you can't do the page up and page down, but you can rotate it. If you hold down the Alt key, you can move it around a little bit more precisely. But all in all, I think it's an extremely good addition, and it's extremely easy to use as well, which is brilliant. So this demonstrates how easy it is to get three props all in a row, switch them around and get them leveled up so all the gates and that match and go as one basically. That's one thing I also found a bit difficult in the past was obviously getting things to line up, especially when they have already, they've already got fences around them. You always want those to match up to the next thing you're putting down, so this sort of eliminates that factor now, and it's a great way of doing that. And as you can see, it's not just the props you can do. This is obviously a power plant from the actual electric category, and you can see I'll turn this all the way around because I'd prefer to have the cables coming out the other end, and it's just an easy rotate. You can then move it closer to the road. It just makes positioning life a lot easier. Now another amazing addition to this mod is the fact you can select more than one actual unit at any one time and move the whole thing around, rotate the whole thing. It's great, especially if you're building up sort of custom builds, maybe a park or so, and you decide you want to move that elsewhere. This is a great way of doing it. You can see here I'm just selecting them all go green, and now I can move them all, I can rotate them all, I can do whatever I want, and they're going to stay exactly in that position. So this is a actual game changer again for people who want to build their own assets and combine things together, but they want to move them around. It's It's incredible, I must say. It's an absolute amazing addition to this game. So for me personally, I'm an absolute perfectionist when it comes to this game. And just the little things that this new mod allows you to do. Like over here, I've got this hot dog stand, but I don't quite like the way it's facing towards the road. I'd rather it be in the middle, and I can just simply now just rotate that round. And to me, that looks a lot more realistic. It looks much more appealing, and it's so simple to do. Also the same when you're looking around, and some of your prop placement may not have been as good as it could have been. If we check over here, there's a few bins here that are actually inside the stadium. So all you do, click the button, find which one it is, and just drag it, either with your cursors, with the mouse, or the keyboard itself. Absolute amazing. Now that's the basis, that's what everyone knows what this mod can do, but also what I've found is it just makes life easier to create your own custom assets within the game. So what we're doing here, this is a very basic and just to give you an idea on how easy it is now to build your own sort of mashup of parts, I guess. And what I'm doing here is just creating a very small sort of stage, I guess, for a music festival. And now, I mean, all you need to do now is find a group or a couple of assets that fit the theme, and you can now just do what you want with them. I know you obviously got to have Anarchy on, etc., to be able to do this, but with this Move It mod, you're now able to move things into the exact position you want. And as you know, if you're trying to do something custom, the first mouse drop is so important. Well, it was so important to be able to do, but now you can pretty much place it anywhere, and you know you've got that ability now to change things up and move things around. So this is just to give you an idea on what you're able to do in terms of using this new mod to move things around. I know it's quite obvious, but some people may have not realized you can use this in this way, and I just wanted to give you guys the heads up that it's a lot easier to do now. And finally, one thing I like to do to make my builds unique is combining buildings next to one another to create a bigger building. And beforehand, I used to have to do this with the roads, putting them in the exact spot to then get the two to overlap in the best position. But now, this mod allows that to be done within seconds. I know sometimes you have to put the roads through the middle to still give it the road connection, but this is how easy it is to do now. You can just place them down on the roads and then pretty much click on the mod icon and then just pick it up and drag it to where you want. So you can make some amazing new builds here with the amazing assets that are on the workshop and pretty much make what you want yourself. You can pretty much make custom builds yourself within the game, and this new mod allows you to do that without having to go on the workshop. It just gives you that extra ability to make the game look and feel exactly how you want to. So, all in all, an absolutely amazing mod. I know I've said that many times, but being a detailer like myself, this has absolutely changed the way I play the game. It saves a lot of time, and it's just a unique new mod that just opens up the game to that next level. And we haven't, these mods come out every now and again. And when they do, it really does change the way you think about the game. And me personally, it opens up new projects, opens up new opportunities to show you guys what I've got going on in my head. So, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy. I'll put a link in the description below. And all the best.